So you've decided to join everyone else and invest in a property, but where should you do it? I'm here with Dr. Andrew Wilson, the senior economist from the Domain Group. Andrew, what are your thoughts?
Well, look, Australia certainly has a strong culture of residential investment, particularly with small investors. And one of the interesting things is it's certainly not that much about the dynamics of residential performance, but about the location. But having said that, there is a growing move from investors to look elsewhere, interstate, for investment hotspots. And we're seeing that particularly in that Sydney market at the moment, which is certainly attracting record levels of investors at the moment. So it's not a short-term view that most investors take, particularly small investors. They do look to the medium, longer term for their investment because they have confidence in the robust and resilient nature of Australia's housing markets. And I always say that if you're looking for short-term gains, go to the racetrack or the casino and you get a lot more excitement out of it. Property investment really is a medium to longer term proposition. And I think Australia, most Australian investors, small investors understand that. And that's a factor that keeps our housing markets in balance over the cycles.
A lot of people have been talking about the Brisbane market. Is that one to watch?
Look, all markets you can watch, because over time the energy of housing cycles reflects each capital city market, because we live in a federated economy. And look, Brisbane certainly has some positives to it. It's a market that's characterised by low vacancy rates. It has a low entry level. Its median house price is well below that of Sydney. And it has rental growth as well. So yields are higher at around 5% compared to Sydney 4%, but it depends on what part of the cycle we're in. And as I said, most investors actually look to their local neighbourhood or their local capital city for investment decisions.
And what's happening in Darwin?
Well, look, Darwin has been Australia's highest priced capital city market, but demand is starting to weaken there, particularly given the downturn in the resources industry, and that means less of the fly-in, fly-out model, which tends to underpin rental demand in Darwin for houses.
Just say you're looking at buying in any capital city, is it better to look in the inner city area or the outer areas?
Well, look, investors typically look at the outer areas because they offer higher yields, and they've got higher yields because they're lower prices, and rents tend to track higher for lower prices than they do for higher priced properties. That differential gets smaller as the price of a house gets higher, the rent gets smaller in relative sense. So the cheaper the house, the higher the yield, and investors look for that, and of course that means typically outer suburban properties.
And there's certainly no shortage of property in Melbourne.
Well, look, Melbourne's certainly a resilient market. I mean, the Melbourne market showed signs of weakening last year. Prices growth was around about half in 2014 what it was in 2013. But what's driving the Melbourne market is the aspirational buyers in mid to higher price sections, particularly in the eastern side of the city and inner suburbs. And that's been really common through Brisbane, Sydney, Melbourne, and Perth and Adelaide.
Thank you very much for that advice, Andrew. I hope everyone got something out of that. See you next time.